Jeremiah 1, verse 4 to 5, and also verses 15 to 19. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. For behold, I am calling all the tribes of the kingdoms of the north, declares the Lord, and they shall come, and every one shall set his throne at the entrance of the gates of Jerusalem, against all its walls all around, and against all the cities of Judah. And I will declare my judgments against them, for all their evil in forsaking me. They have made offerings to other gods, and worshipped the works of their own hands. But you, dress yourself for work. Arise, and say to them everything that I command you. Do not be dismayed by them, lest I dismay you before them. And I, behold, I make you this day a fortified city, an iron pillar, and bronze walls, against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, its officials, its priests, and the people of the land. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you, for I am with you, declares the Lord, to deliver you. During the summer, I went to Rasili, to the sunflower fields that are there. And for those of you that haven't been there before, it's a huge field full of row upon row of sunflowers of different varieties, and it's quite a sight to behold. And you're also able to walk in amongst those sunflowers, the sunflower going through the sunflower field. And whilst I was doing that, you obviously take lots of photos. But as we looked closer, you also saw bees at work on some of the sunflowers in the on the centre. And you saw one, then you saw another and another, and you realised that there were lots of bees at work on these sunflowers. And you took photos of it as well, because it was such a remarkable sight. And a little bit further on, about a 5-minute walk towards the coast, is what's known as Worm's Head. And I was sat on the coast enjoying the sun, and I noticed another bee. And it was getting on with its job on a tiny little yellow flower. And it was happily getting on with its job. No one was there to see what the work that that bee was doing. No one was taking photos of it at work. And it got me thinking, imagining bees being given their job in the morning, queuing up in the morning with a queen bee giving out various different jobs. The top job being that sunflower field, getting to work in the sunflower field. And this bee in the morning in the queue hoping that gets the top job in being in the sunflower field, where people might flock to see him at work, and also taking photos of him at work. And then as it gets to his turn, he's given that job and he's told, you haven't got that job. And the disappointment that bee must have experienced. And yet, goes out and gets on with the job that he's been given. In the passage that I read, it's Jeremiah's call. And it's such a discouraging call. He's told by the Lord that he's been chosen to be a prophet. And yet, if you read the whole of Jeremiah 1, it's probably the most there's not any encouragement in it. There are very negative words in there about the response to God's words that Jeremiah is going to experience. And yet, Jeremiah still goes and does God's work because God has called him to do it. And then if we relate it to us, many of us may be involved in church work. And it can be discouraging if you haven't seen many converts. Preachers may not have many in their congregation. And some of us may not even have what's known as, you know, the big jobs or on the front line, if you like. And yet, each of us have been given skills by God. And we're to use those skills for God's glory. Whether that be being able to speak in front of big groups, whether that be being able to speak to groups of children and make it understandable to their level, whether that be being called to be a preacher. Some people might not have those roles, but they might have others, like very much been noticed during lockdown. Those were the skills of IT. Like right now, I have no idea how the video I'm currently recording ends up on YouTube. Not a clue. But there are people who have those skills And God uses those skills to further his work. There are maybe people out there who their skill is the ability to pray and to relate to a lot of people, to get alongside people and check in on how they are and then bring that concern to God. Use that skill. There might be those that only have family and children. Teach them God's word. You might have skills in finance. You can use those skills to God's glory. As a church, we have to fulfill certain financial obligations and follow regulations, health and safety. All of these things we can do to God's glory. And you might feel discouraged because you don't feel that you're seeing or having an impact on someone being saved. And yet, in one sense, it's not for us to worry. Ours is to do the work, but it's to God's glory that it is for. The converts are for God, but we are to do God's work. And I'd ask you, what is your call? What is it that God is calling you to do? Is it to preach? Is it to take part in youth work? Or is it something that's less of a frontline role, if you want to call it that, but more of a behind the scenes role, and yet just as valid, just as valuable to furthering God's work, to sharing God's word? Because without it, it wouldn't be possible to share God's word. Those of you that haven't seen those converts, it's right to yearn to see more, and yet also to be satisfied with the work that you've been given, and to do it with a joyful heart.